Hey guys, Dan Duran here one last time. We are here on the Hack the Box Starting Point Marathon Tier 0. So we're on the last one, the last box of Tier 0 in here. Learn the basics of penetration testing. So today we are doing synced. All right, so let me just reset this machine and let's get to it. All right, so the first one is, what is the default port for our sync? And to be honest, I'm not sure, so let's find out. So let's just do a quick search on that. RSYNC default port, and that's A73. All right, perfect. So A73. How many TCP ports are open on the remote host? All right, so let's do an nmap. Let me just copy this IP address, get into here, and then let's do a quick nmap on this, right? So what we're gonna do here is change this to SV. Then I'm not gonna do the operating system. I am going to do no ping. I'm also going to do all ports, and maybe I can throw in a T4 like that. And let's do this. All right, so we see that there's only one port open, which is A73 RSYNC protocol version 31. Okay, so the next question, how many TCP ports are there open? Only one. What is the protocol version used by RSYNC? That's 31, we already saw that, submit that. What is the most common command name on Linux to interact with RSYNC? That is RSYNC, of course, and I'll show you that in a bit. What credentials do you have to pass to RSYNC in order to use anonymous authentication? Anonymous, non-RSYNC, RSYNC, and that would be none. So you don't put any. And number six, what is the option to only list shares and files on RSYNC? I'm going to show you how to do this. So let's get in here. Let me just clean this up and let's do a man RSYNC. And these are all the options that you can do for RSYNC. How to pull, how to push, right? If you can't find information, then you can do two things that I think are very helpful, right? So let me just quit the man in here. The first one would be, let's do a grep. So what we can do is RSYNC like that, and then we're going to do help and then grep, and then we can do list or copy or whatever you want, right? So let's see, we're listing. So let's do a list, and then you'll see here that it says list only, right? So that would be list only. And then how to get the root flag. So let's connect to RSYNC. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is RSYNC. We're gonna do another RSYNC like this, column slash slash the IP address. Oh, I already got the flag for this, so don't mind me. All right, so what we're gonna do is RSYNC. And with this, we're gonna connect to RSYNC and see what is out there. So we just wait for a little bit. There, so you can see that there's one sharing here on the public, right? So this is the one that we want. Now, if I do the same thing, and then I put public in here like that, there you go. You see that there is a flag in here, right? So we want to get that flag, but we can't cat into RSYNC. We can only get the information. So for that, if you type in TLDR RSYNC, and if you don't have TLDR, I suggest you install it as well. Just apt install TLDR, and then it'll give you kind of what you need to be able to get information. So over here, transfer files from remote to host, you have to put the RSYNC command and then the path to the local directory at the very end. So that's how we transfer information. So let me just do this, the same thing here again, right? And then from here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna put that, and we're gonna also do flag.txt like that, right? So we already saw that there is the flag in there. So let me just go back a little bit. So right there, after we did our RSYNC command right here. So we just had to follow it up with the next command and then put our local directory in here. And then let's get the flag. All right, perfect. So now if we do an ls, there is the flag. So cat flag, and there it is. Very easy to use RSYNC. And you know what? RSYNC is so powerful. I love doing RSYNC. It is a pretty good command to use in the Linux world, right? So let's submit the flag and success. All right, super easy. And that concludes tier 0. So we're gonna move on to tier 1 and then tier 2 to finish up the starting point for Hack the Box. If you have any questions, any comments, make sure you post them down below, and I hope to see you in the next video. Cheers.